Zeno Education Society, redefining excellence.
Hello friends, my name is Vijay Kotambe, Zil Polytechnic at Narre Pune. I will explain my project under the guidance Majaz Sheikh sir. Vision and mission of department: vision to create competent, self-disciplined, morally strong civil engineers with capabilities of accepting challenges of ever advancing technology for the benefits of society. My project name is Self-Healing Concrete and the subject is Emerging Trends in Civil Engineering. Introduction: concrete is a material which is the most widely used building material in the world. Natural processes such as weathering, faults and subsidence, earthquakes and human activities creates cracks in concrete structures. Concrete expands and shrinks with the changes in moisture and temperature, and this tendency to shrink and expand causes cracks in concrete. The various products such as structural epoxy resins, epoxy mortar and other synthetic mixtures are used as filling materials, but they are not environmentally friendly, not even safe for human health. Here are some four possible mechanisms given for self-healing of concrete, which are as under. First one, formation of material like calcite. Second, blocking of the path by sedimentation of particles. Third, continued hydration of cement particles. Fourth, swelling of the surrounding cement matrix. Comparison of characteristics of bacterial concrete and concrete without bacteria through some of the test result. First, effect of the bacteria to various depth of cracks on stiffness. Beam size of 152 by 25.4 by 25.5 by 4 mm, cured for 28 days and keep exposed to air for 3 months. Artificial cracks of depth 3.2 mm and 9.5 mm were cut on beam. For each depth of cracks made 10 specimens, among them 5 were filled with bacteria, 5 without bacteria kept as it is. Test using 1-point loading system. In results, specimen which were treated with bacteria showed higher compressive strength from results at concentration of 8.6 by 10.8 cells per mm. Found increased maximum compressive strength and this concentration is taken as optimum concentration. Reason why higher concentration did not give higher compressive strength may be because greater population of bacteria did not have enough nutrients to share. Conclusion: it was found that beams with the micro cracks remediated with the bacteria concentration of 8.6 into 10 raised to 8 cells per mm of water regained 10% of its original strength. Higher concentration reduces the regaining strength of concrete. It was found that specimen with bacteria improve its permeability and resistance to alkaline environment, sulfate attack and freeze that reaction. Thus we can say that cracks remediated with bacteria can improve the strength and durability of structure. This all observation were done in America. These results we cannot directly considered valid for our country because of difference in temperature, humidity, type of concrete, control on various parameters such as type of concrete, mix, etc. In India, porosity and permeability of concrete should be studied because they are the main causes of distress in many structures. References: Ram Charan S.K., Ram Krishna V. and Bank S.S. Remediation of concrete using microorganism ACI materials general V98 number 1 pp 39 Jan to Feb 2001. Remark Krishna V. Ramesh Panchalan and Bang SS. Bacteria concrete, a self remediating biometrical proceeding of 10th International Congress on the polymers in concrete, Hawaii, May 2001, a textbook of concrete technology by MSCT. http://www.tubeft.nl/live/pagina.jsp. ID is equal to 86912221D. EBAB4841-97CB-1CFACAD3A4BC and LANG is equal to NL. http://www.economist.com/science/displaystory.cfm/story. ID is equal to 1357005. Thank you.